Hello and welcome. And today I'm gonna make another, basic stuff video, so to say. And as you already read in the title, it's about how to kite and push correctly. What does it mean? For all the people that are not so familiar with the expressions, kiting is what you mainly or what you should mainly do in a cruiser. Means you evade from the enemy pressure to make them lo lose HP or ships, and in the end to counter push if everything was successful, if you kite correctly and had enough firepower to chunk them down. That's basically what kiting and pushing is about. I will speak or talk about how you kite in the best way and what things you need to pay attention to, and when pushing the same thing around as well. But first of all, some basic knowledge. So give me a sec. Yeah, basic knowledge. All right, for all the people that are not so familiar with the game, that's why I call it basic stuff. There are always two types of cruisers in this game, and especially on the high tiers, so like tier 9, tier 10, you will find these, or they are really separated. For example, the tier 10 American cruiser, the Des Moines, or one of the tier 10 American cruisers, because there's a light cruiser coming as well, but he's probably stationary as well, is a stationary cruiser. And that's why, because he's bad at kiting. It's pretty simple. He is sitting high in the water and is therefore, and the rudder shift and the firing arcs are not really optimal for kiting. That's why it's best played in stationary safe positions and lopping shells somewhere. Same will count for the Worcester, I think. Moskva is, for example, the same thing, even though I think the Moskva is a better kiter than the Des Moines because it has the armor to tank it as well. It's also a big downside with the Des Moines, the armor is really lacking. Okay, so we have these two differentiations between kiting and stationary cruisers. One fact about cruisers that, at least the ones among you that are a bit more experienced, know that in the start of a battle, when there are 12 ships each side and you're in a cruiser, especially on high tiers, it's not so problematic, but especially on lower tiers and mid tiers where you don't have a heal or access to a heal, you wanna conserve as much HP as possible to play aggressive in the start, to play aggressive in the end. So the more HP you conserved over the time, the more freedom you have in the late game, and you can chunk down enemy ships pretty easily, which is pretty good if you manage that. Okay, that are the two basic facts which you should know about cruiser play in general. There was no other point right now, so I'm going over to the kiting part. Give me a sec. So, when kiting away. Alright, what are the things you have to pay attention to? First of all, you want to kite into a position from where you are not, from where you are most annoying. That's especially counting for battleships. So I can check it here on the map. So let's say the enemy is pushing here. Or like, don't think about these rocks. Think they are not here. So they are pushing like this. So you don't want to push like kite away like this. You want to push kite away like this, because then they mostly likely have the guns into this direction, especially it's a thing of the battleships, and not in this direction. So by kiting in this position and just appearing here and shooting into their broadsides, or you are absolutely a nuisance to your to the enemy battleships, for example. And that's where you want to be if you can. Of course, if they are heavily pushing, your forces are really slow. There's always a danger of getting boxed in, so you have to consider this as well. Are you managing to chunk enough ships down that you can get out of here, or do you have to kite away here as well because of this? Because then you have, of course, to go this way. But the optimal way would be in this area here. Alright, that's the first point. If you await shells by kiting away, never do the same move all the time. Because a smart battleship, it's mostly battleship players, or also cruiser players, but mostly battleship players, because they can inflict the most damage, they will see a pattern at a, after a while, and then just adapt to it and will fire where they expect you to turn to. So keep that in mind. I mean, for the normal battleship potato, sorry for all the battleship players I'm insulting right now, but for the average player, well, they don't care, I can tell you that. Make sure to be angled when the shells are coming in, especially when battleship shells are coming. Then you want to present the armor belt, because the armor belt is able to bounce some shells. I mean, not probably no Yamato shells, even though I heard that can happen as well, but yeah, normally you can reduce or mitigate the damage if you do that. Especially in like stationary cruisers, or in cruisers like Moskva, which have a pretty strong armor belt. Yeah, next point is... that's a thing I need to put in another part. Another thing is, don't kite too far away. Or another point. It's just as simple, because I see people, they know what kiting is, but they end up in the at the map border when it isn't necessary. It's not as if some ships, even cruisers, can tank a bit. Yeah? And yeah, some are just like, yeah, just kiting too far, and then they are out of battle. And yeah, often there is a reason why they lose a game because of this. So always make sure not to be too far away, and yeah, then for like 5 minutes out of the battle, because that can be really crucial if you win the game or not. Okay, that was the kiting part. I think it was, or I hope it was understandable. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask in the comments below. I'm gladly answering everything. I'm here for it, that you learn something. So yeah, whenever you have questions or replay analysis, just let me know, and it's fine. Alright, so the last part is when pushing, because it was kiting and pushing. Of course, as I said in the definition, what is kiting, or yeah, it's the evasion of enemy pressure to make them lose HP or ships until you are strong enough to counter push. And yeah, if you push, you need to consider some things as well. So let's go over this as well. When should you counter push, so to say? Well, that's pretty simple. If you can overwhelm the enemy in terms of firepower or number of ships or ships class. So if you have like 3 battleships, 1 DD and 1 cruiser against like 1 battleship, 2 cruisers and no DD, then of course you go you're able to yeah, push them away at least. I mean, pushing doesn't mean to kill them, it means pushing them away. People often tend to misunderstand this. You don't have to push all the way down the road, so to say, and then not achieving anything except that you lose a lot of HP. You gain the control of the certain point or target you wanted to achieve, but in the end the enemy is kiting you, and which is always unfavorable for you, because if someone is kiting correctly, he's always in a favorable position, because the one who runs after the kiter is always losing more HP than the kiter itself. It's just easy because the ranges of the guns, if you go max ranges, the guy who's kiting away, they have a shorter travel time, while the guy who's shooting at the one who's kiting away has a has a longer travel time when it comes to shells. So he's not as reliable when hitting, for example. And that makes a difference in the in the damage output, so to say. Okay, so if you overwhelm the enemy or push him away, the next point would be focus your fire. Focus fire is really important, because without focus fire, you don't do much. Because if everybody shoots a different target, then you never will reduce the number of enemy ships. And yeah, I mean, sometimes it's not possible, but try it at least. I mean, it's a bit euphemistic to say in random battles something like this is working out, but I think with a F3 key of a target, if you know which target is the most important or the lowest HP, then you just go for it and you target him, and normally your team will follow you because they realize, yeah, that's probably right, and that's okay, so I'm going to focus that target as well. That's pretty simple, I would say. If you are in the aggressive mode, means you are pushing, then you can just always wiggle and shoot all your guns. Or, I mean, depends on how many battleships you are pushing against. Normally, it should only be one. That would be the best choice. If not, it's a big of an issue, a thing of an issue, I think. But you can stay unangled until he's shooting, and then you should angle. So that results in a little wiggle from time to time. So you shoot your front and then your back guns, and so on and so on and so on, which is pretty. Gegnerische Schlachtschiff zerstört. Yeah, how to say? Pretty normal, if you know what I mean. If there is a carrier in game, try to stick together like we guys do here, for example, if you see it in the background. I'm giving here AA defense for the Kofus, but I think it's probably too late, yeah. Wiggling all the guns also. Sorry, I lost the point. I'm reading here, but because it's a lot of stuff to talk about. So you can do this wiggle thing all the time and shoot all your guns until you are really close. So depends on how good your gun angles are. You can wiggle a bit more, and because your rudder shift is also a factor, because that shows how quickly your stern can go into line again. So just do it until you are approximately 10 kilometers away from the enemy, because then it's gonna be getting a bit critical if you show too much broadside. And after that point, just use your front guns. It's always, by the way, a rune is, for example, really good at kiting, but really bad at pushing, because there is only one front gun with triple turret, which is quite a significant firepower disadvantage when it comes to pushing. Sorry, my nose is running. And a different thing is, or another point is, if you get focused down, I mean, if the enemy is smart, they will focus one ship down of yours anyways, so then you are, if you lost too much HP, then you slow down and heal up if possible. I mean, in a cruiser like TA or like tier 6 and so on, let the battleships lead it and stay a bit behind, because otherwise it's gonna be a mess. Because you can't tank anything in the light cruisers of tier 6 and below. So in that regard, you need to play a bit different and even more careful. But still, I mean, on tier 10, Hindenburgs really good at tanking. Moskvas for pushing really, really good. Even Henri is quite okay, even though it has only a 25mm armor. Zhao can also use its concealment, but not so so great when pushing. Yeah, and also a part is if you are turning to push, make sure, and that's really a really important thing, make sure that you wait until you are dark or concealed, and then you are going for the turn, not before. A smart battleship player will wait for this, and if you start the turn and then go undetected, he will shoot and assume that you will make a full turn, for example. So keep that in mind. Good players will adjust to that. Normal ones, not so much. But that's a really important thing, because then you don't have to show too much broadside, for example. And it's an often made mistake. People are just also, like, if they end up in front of the enemy and they have the concealment to do it, or to, how to say, to go dark again, they still go full, yeah, turning full in front of the enemy fleet, and then of course die or lose a lot of HP. Totally unnecessary. Instead of, like, not panicking, slowing down, don't go closer to the enemy, maybe even reverse, but only if you can turn away, so to say. Then, yeah, try to avoid this. Is there anything I'm missing right now? Give me a sec. Oh yeah, always pay attention to the minimap. Well, that's anyways a general rule in my opinion, but yeah, people tend to forget about it, and yeah, that's always another advice in this regard, because people tend to push into nowhere. It's the same like kiting into nowhere. There's always this push into nowhere. When you can remember, I fought that Bismarck up here. I could have gone this way and followed the Minotaur, but I saw there is nothing. But instead I went straight here to have more impact on the game. So people tend to do like going into the enemy spawn and so on, not paying attention. And yeah, try to avoid this, because yeah, as the other thing, it doesn't help your team too much if you do it, and therefore you should avoid it. All right, I think that were all the points. Sorry if I got a bit stuck from while to while, but yeah, that is a lot of text I had, and yeah, was not so easy to tell you all the stuff in that short time. Okay, yeah, hope you enjoyed it, hope it helped you. As I said, write something in the comments if you have something to add or to ask. Otherwise, give it a like, that would be appreciated. And yeah, in the end, have a nice weekend, enjoy your days, and see you next time. Bye bye.